Fish passage at dam structures is a significant concern for the Bureau of Reclamation and other agencies like the Corps of Engineers and Tennessee Valley Authority and other agencies that build dams. We have a range of what we call low head dams and high head dams, dams that are everything from 5 or 6 feet high across a river channel to several hundred feet high.
Salmon are anadromous species. They come from the ocean and head upstream to spawn. And their historic habitat is upstream of these dams. And a big challenge is collecting the juveniles when they come from the upstream habitats back downstream. It'd be great to come up with a better solution to actually collect those juveniles as they come downstream and successfully get them below the dam so they can complete their life cycle.
Downstream fish passages is a wide range of issues where we're just trying to capitalize on the fish's behavior and instincts and hydraulic conditions to move the fish safely downstream of dams.
Currently, the ways for passing fish downstream of dams are penstock screens, turbines, over spillways, bypass channels and pipes, existing fish ladders, or specially designed floating surface collectors where we can collect the fish and then truck transport them downstream of the dam.
We're trying to understand and improve the different methods that we have to be able to pass fish, whether it be the surface passage routes, bringing fish off the surface, or whether it's collection at different elevations within the dam.
For this prize competition, we are interested in collecting juvenile fish in the reservoir for transport downstream. There are some challenges with collecting fish in the reservoir. The fish can have a very difficult time finding a single collection point in a very large reservoir. They may never find the point, or they may be significantly delayed in finding it. Large storage reservoirs can also fluctuate in water surface elevation by up to 150 feet. So the bypass system or the collector needs to be able to accommodate this large water surface elevation change.
Ideal solution to fish passage would definitely improve the likelihood that we would be able to sustain endangered and threatened fish species. A system that would allow passage at all times without human intervention would have substantial positive impacts on threatened and endangered fish species.
Many times great ideas can come from non-engineers, non-biologists, and non-scientists. And in fact, that's how many great ideas have started. And the goal is to open it up to anybody that may have ideas.
The Bureau of Reclamation is partnering with the U.S. Geological Survey, the Army Corps of Engineers, NOAA's National Marine Fisheries Service, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, and the California Department of Water Resources on this prize competition. All of these agencies are interested in fish recovery efforts for threatened and endangered species under the Endangered Species Act.